Welcome students, this is Premlata TGT Social Science handling history class for you today. We are here to deal with the outbreak of World War I and its aftermath. The chapter has an elaborate version of the outbreak of the First World War. It deals with Russian Revolution, League of Nations, etc.
Unit 1, Outbreak of World War I and its aftermath. In this chapter, we deal with the outbreak of the First World War, the Russian Revolution, the formation of International Peace Organization and League of Nations. Coming to the first one, outbreak of the First World War. What is the reason for the outbreak of First World War? We find that in the later half of the 19th century, there was rapid industrialization and colonization, as a result of which there was race among the capitalist powers to emerge as a dominant power. Therefore, there was exploitation of resources and they also wanted to explore new markets. In this chapter, there are some terms which we have to understand, some basic simple terms: industrialization and colonization, capitalism and imperialism. What is industrialization? Industrialization means a process by which an economy which is primarily agricultural transforms to one based on manufacturing of goods. Here, individual labor is replaced by mass mechanized production. Colonization: the action or process of settling among and establishing control over people of an area for one's own use is colonization. In other words, it means trying to get control over another country to get more land for their people to live or to settle. Capitalism. What is capitalism? It is an economic system in which the government plays a secondary role and the people and the private owners make most of the decisions and own most of the property. This means that the companies are operated for profit. Coming to imperialism. What is imperialism? It is the policy of extending a country's rule over the other through colonization and military force or by any other means of arrogance. So, imperialism is the highest form of capitalism. So, coming to the next head, clash among the great powers. So, there was the continuous race for expanding the empire led to exploitation of resources around the world. In many countries, the corporations dominated the government. There was a mismatch between the rising industries and surplus market on one side, that is extreme wealth, and extreme poverty on the other hand. Europe already had colonized many Asian countries and only Africa was left. They left very little avenues for exploitation to other countries, which caused frequent clashes between them. So after 1870, England, France, Belgium, Italy and Germany, they joined the scramble. Rise of Japan. Following European countries, Japan also wanted to follow imperialism. Therefore, in 1894, Japan forced a war on China and annexed Liaotung and Port Arthur. So, this is known as the Chino-Japanese War. But the strong pressure from the European nations forced Japan to give away Port Arthur. Seeing the situation and taking advantage of the situation, Russia marched with its troops to Manchuria in 1902. However, due to the alliance of Japan with England, Russia had to withdraw its troops. So this is the Russo-Japanese War, which occurred in 1904. Again, taking the reason of assassination of the Japanese diplomat in 1905, Japan took control over Russia. In 1912, there was a fall of Manchu dynasty in China. So the fall of Manchu rule in China in 1912 made Japan to extend its control over Shantung, and it demanded appointment of Japanese advisors to the Chinese government. Now coming to colonization and its fallout. By this time, major portion of Africa was occupied by colonies. 10% was under the European rule. The division of Africa between France, Belgium, and Britain occurred. Russia and Germany had influence over China. Japan took over Korea and Taiwan. USA took Philippines from Spain. Britain and Russia partitioned Iran. So this attempt to carve more colonies and the spirit of nationalism that grew stronger contributed decisively to the outbreak of war and hence the fallout of colonies. Coming to causes of the World War. The First World War, what are the causes? The first one, the European alliances and counter-alliances. Under Bismarck, Germany, Austria-Hungary and Italy, they formed a triple alliance in 1882. And in 1894, Russia and France allied together. Japan allied with Britain. France allied with Britain, that is Entente Cordiale, in 1904. Already there was some dispute between division of Morocco and Egypt between the France and Britain colonies. So France agreed to give away Egypt to Britain and had to retain Morocco. Britain reached an agreement with Russia over Persia, Afghanistan and also Tibet, and this is known as the Triple Entente. So the Triple Entente was between Britain, France and Russia. What are the forms of nationalism? There are various forms of nationalism. The first one is Jingoism, which is followed in England, Chauvinism of France and Kultur of Germany. The growth of nationalism caused love for one country which demanded hatred for another. The attitude that right or wrong, I support my country was developed among the people. The aggressive attitude of the German emperor. William Kaiser II of Germany was very aggressive and proclaimed Germany as the leader of the world. It extended its naval base, which convinced Britain of some form of attack. Hence, tension existed between the two powers. France was very hostile to Germany. In 1871, France had already lost Alsace and Lorraine to Germany. So they had some bitter experiences with Germany, and this they always retained. Now there was German interference in Morocco. Germany demanded an international conference to decide on the future of Morocco. The imperial power politics in the Balkans. Coming to the Balkans. After the Turkish Revolution, Austria and Russia decided to resume their power in the Balkans. There was an agreement between Austria and Russia that Austria would annex Bosnia and Russia shall move her warships through Bosporus to the Mediterranean. After annexation of Bosnia by Austria was opposed by Serbia. Germany promised to support Austria against Serbia if they invaded Serbia. So this led to the outbreak of war in 1914. So the Balkan Wars, 1912-13. Why there was a war in the Balkan area? The political and economic instability in the Turkish Empire is one of the reasons. Greece seceded from the Turkish control and various other nations followed. Greece, Bulgaria, Serbia, Montenegro, they wanted to take control over Macedonia. So they formed a league. And this league attacked the Turkish forces. That is the first Balkan War. And the Turkish forces were totally defeated by the League countries, and finally a treaty had to be signed, and that is the Treaty of London. A new state, Albania, is formed, and Turkey is reduced to the area of Constantinople. There was a second Balkan War. Why this occurred? Because Bulgaria was not satisfied over the division of Macedonia. So Bulgaria attacked Greece and Serbia. Finally, Bulgaria suffered a heavy defeat and therefore had to sign a treaty, and that is the Treaty of Bucharest in 1913. So far we have seen the causes of the war. Now here is the assignment for you. What is imperialism? What are the forms of nationalism? Who was the leader of Germany during World War I? Explain the Balkan War and explain the cause of World War I.
At the end of the lesson, I have given you some assignment questions. Please go through the questions and try to answer them promptly.